38 years as a PGA golf professional. If it wasn't for junior golf, I wouldn't be standing here today after all these years. I'd say real simply, education. You've got to find a separator, and there's no guarantees in life. So make sure that you go to college with a purpose to get your education, number one. Real easy to get caught up in chasing this dream of playing on this tour or this professional sport or what have you, but your education cannot be sacrificed. Literally, injury, you know, one swing away, one play away, you just never know what tomorrow is going to bring. So I see too many young men and women who put all their eggs in this one basket, and they kind of go through life in, with a small amount of focus on the education side when it should have been completely the opposite. So education has got to be first and foremost. When you finish your college education, then go out and find that next level of excellence in your life, whether it be a master's degree, a certification of some sort. Be a career learner. Education. Number two, you got to make decisions, right decisions, and you got to learn how to say no. Listen, at the end of the day, it's not about anything but where you're going to go, what your goals are, what your objectives in life are, and how you're going to get there. So you need to put people around you that want to share that vision and dream with you, simply. A lot of times you see athletes, high-performing young men and women, who put the wrong people around them. They listen to the wrong individuals telling them to do the wrong things. Listen, it's okay to say no when you're making decisions. It's okay to say, no, I can't go. I've got to study. I've got to be focused. I've got to get a good night's sleep. It's okay to say no. Fitting in with your peers is one thing, but when it costs you your dreams and your goals, like I see it all the time for decades, don't let that be you. Put the right people around you. Number one, it's your parents. It's your support group that will always be there for you. So that's my advice as well. Make really good decisions and learn how to say no early in the game. There's a formula to high performance and success in life. It's high performance equals potential minus distraction. It's extraordinarily simple. And breaking it down to the basics, as you would do when you play golf at a high level, it's about the fundamentals. Stay in the lanes of fundamentals. If you seek high performance and success in your life, and you can call it anything you want to, golf, sport, life, relationship, religion, call it anything you want to. If it's high performance you seek, and if you have the potential, be honest with yourself. Not everyone can play on the PGA Tour. Not everyone can work for Disney. Not everybody can work at a Ritz-Carlton hotel. Not everybody can take on a path in life. If you have the potential, and you can check that box, and you know in your heart you can check the box, it's the distraction formula. High performance equals potential minus distraction. This is where it all falls down. Cell phones, social media, relationships, cars, trying to be something other than you are, not being with your feet on the ground and remembering where you came from. These are the formulas of distraction. This is the formula where you don't reach where you want to go in life. This is America. We live in a country where you can set your dreams and goals at the highest levels and you can achieve. That formula is non-deniable. High performance or success, however you want to measure it. If you've got the potential, and if you're a member of the AJGA and you're out playing on this tour, check that box. It's about these distractions that you have to manage. And lastly, it's real simple. Pay it forward. Give something back. You're going to find at some point in your life that the more you give, the more you will receive. There's a person that's looking up to you right now that you have absolutely no idea. There's a young junior golfer. If you're out on the AJGA Tour, if you're one of your top high school players, if you're a player in your community that's being looked up to, and you're out and have the ability to play on this tour, then you already are a role model to somebody. Turn around and look at that person and bring them into this game and put your arm around that little junior golfer, that little kid over there, that little junior league kid, that drive chip and putt kid. Bring somebody else into this game who's already trying to be you. Don't forget, you're a role model too. Act like it, walk tall, and represent the AJGA, the greatest junior golf association on the planet Earth. Those are my little keys to success. I hope just one of them might work for you. God bless. Keep playing golf. It's the greatest game in the world.